located at Stockholm Södra railway station, and it serves just two floors. It replaced the Diva elevator, but this elevator itself has some very epic features. In fact, you don't need to press any buttons at all. It is fitted with motion sensors at all buttons. And it is also fitted with cab detection that shows the other floor for you. So if you really love the touchless elevator, then vote for Atlas Transporting Adventures. Lake Erie Greyfell, something in an Ontario hydraulic elevator that uses dew brush to fix. This elevator is located at the Festival Theatre in Stratford, Ontario, and it serves four floors. Some things I noted here is the double bus and classic band shower, as well as the floor indicator. The elevator has some very gorgeous walls and otherwise metals around. The theater is known for its Shakespearean plays, thus the title named for this elevator. So if you like this Shakespearean elevator, then vote for Lake Erie Greyfell. Finnish Lifttorch sent me in a 1934 built Siemens Schuckert traction elevator. This freighter has schizo gates, it's slightly updated in 96 clicks and is manually controlled with a crank. It is located at Turun, Ecuador, and it serves a total of 5 floors. It is not manual too. The elevator has been made so it can stop automatically and safely in level with the top and bottom floors. The elevator is bottom-driven traction elevator, and it is single speed. So if you want one of a very few European manual-controlled elevator to win, then vote for Finnish Lifttorch. You are voting by write in the comment section below. Keep an eye for other rounds as there might appear several rounds every day. Tune in for the Elevator Podcast live every Friday night to see the voting results for each contest this week. And don't forget to subscribe, put a like, and have a good one.